Stuart, the Scottish Seagull, written by Mo Hendricks, illustrated by Elizabeth Glacier. Stuart was a seagull who lived in a quiet seaside town called Dunbar on the east coast of Scotland. Scotland is a part of a beautiful island country called Britain. Because it is an island, there is water on all sides and many places for seagull families to live. Stuart spent his whole life living among the Dunbar fishermen and their families who came to fish and walk on the beaches and jetties in the little harbor on the sea. There was always something to watch in the harbor, and more importantly to Stuart, there was always something to eat. Stuart especially liked the summer when children dropped their ice lollies and play pieces amongst the rocks and shore. One particularly fine June day, Stuart was soaring when he spotted something pink on the harbor wall. He also saw his group of seagull friends close by. Stuart was afraid he would lose out on the tasty morsel, so he dived hard from high above, dropped down, and quickly gobbled up the pink blob in one big swoop of his open beak. Funny, it didn't taste like strawberry ice cream, which is what he expected it to be. It didn't melt in his mouth the way ice cream does. It did, however, have a very sweet taste, and Stuart was especially pleased with himself. He had gotten all of it, and didn't have to share any with his friends. Stuart hadn't learned how important sharing is. He loved the sweet taste, but as he tried to move it about in his mouth, he found he couldn't budge it. It became stuck. The harder he tried, the more stuck it felt. Standing on one leg, a very easy thing for seagulls to do, and putting the other leg between his beak, he tried to pry open his mouth. It stretched open, but somehow the gooey mess connected his top and lower bill with stuck, long, sticky fibers. He opened his bill wider to reveal the mystery inside. Oh no! In his selfish haste, he had gobbled up a gigantic piece of pink bubblegum. His mother's words had warned him over and over again, never, ever eat bubblegum. What was Stuart to do? The sweetness that Stuart first felt when the gum entered his mouth was replaced with thoughts of panic. What if I can't get this out of my mouth? What if I can never open my beak again? Will I be able to drink from the North Sea? Will I be able to eat the children's leftover sweeties? Will I be able to peck at this fisherman's catches of the day? What will I do? If I can't open my beak, how will I squawk? We all know how seagulls love to squawk. Once again, Stuart tried to pry his mouth open using one of his wings and a leg. Remember, it's a very easy thing for the seagulls to stand on one leg. This time, the wing became trapped in the pink sticky mess, and he was now hobbling around with only one good wing and only one good leg. Stuart began thinking very scary thoughts for a seagull. If I do not have my two wings, how will I fly? Will I ever see the waters of Scotland from high above the clouds? Will I ever see the rolling hillsides abloom in purple Scottish heather or beautiful yellow gorse? Will I ever be able to fly to my roost set among the yellow ruins of Dunbar Castle or back in the sun on Bass Rock? Stuart was feeling very sad and also very tired from all of his hard work, trying to free himself. Just then, his group of friends noticed Stuart's problem. They quickly flew to his side, and picking him up, they rested Stuart among their bodies. They flew him to the sandy part of the beach where the tide was still out. two friends, Bailey and Beckett, flew to the fishmonger and collected ice, filling their beaks to bursting. Graham and Fiona, Stuart's other friends, dug a hole in the sand nearby. Once the hole was filled with ice, his friends placed Stuart's beak and wings in the hole. As the cold ice began to freeze the bubblegum, it became less sticky. All four seagulls pecked the little bits of pink, removing them from Stuart's trap wing. They pecked and pecked, and soon the wing was free. Stuart was happy. He knew he would be able to once again fly over the Scottish countryside and see coos grazing on the hills or dive into the sea to get herring. When Stuart remembered he was not free from the mess in his mouth, he would not be able to fly, and he wouldn't be able to eat fish for his supper. The four seagulls made many more trips to collect ice and pack it around the long beak. The fishmonger kept shooing them away from the fish boxes, but the seagulls returned time and time again. They worked tirelessly all afternoon, packing and pecking, packing and pecking. Stuart realized how generous his friends were and how selfish he had been. He hung his head in shame. Bit by bit, little by little, they began to free Stuart of the bubblegum. Finally, all the bits lay among the sand, and no more could be found in his mouth. Stuart opened his mouth slowly, and the first thing that came out of Stuart was not a long squawk, but as we all know, seagulls love to squawk, but instead a very quiet and humble thank you.